Hi guys, it's Infinity 3rd Edition week here at Beasts of War. I'm Killian, this is Carlos from Corvus Belli. We're going to be discussing some of the changes to hacking rules in Infinity 3rd Edition. So Carlos, how's hacking going to change in Infinity 3rd Edition?
It's more than a change, it's really a reconsider the whole set of hacking rules. I realized that it was very confusing, very badly structured. Okay, and once again, as close combat, as weapons and stuff, the new way of explaining this will be with a chart, with programs, with many similarities to shooting, mm-hmm. and with many similarities to close combat, you know, getting things inside those frames, you know, that we know that work and people understand, okay?
Okay.
Not depending so much on strange explanations, mixing fluff and rules and getting more to the game and letting the fluff be in other sides of the book. So, the mechanics of hackers still work with Zone of Control,
yep.
okay? So hackers don't need to have a line of sight to operate, but they have to be close. They have to be 8 inches close,
mm-hmm.
or they have to extend their influence through repeaters, okay? Once they get the objective, they can act and execute their programs and stuff. More stuff. There are already 3 hacker devices in Infinity.
Mm-hmm.
The defensive hacker device, the normal hacker device, the hacker device plus, and there will be a new one, which is the assault hacker device,
assault
and probably
device?
More stuff in the future,
okay.
after television even. Depending which device does the troop have, it gives you access to certain programs.
Mm-hmm.
And those programs, well, there are a lot of programs, okay?
Mm-hmm.
They are like weapons, okay? And they have categories of anti-hacker protocols, support, sword, shield, you know, for attacking, for being very more aggressive. Lots of situations here, and those there is almost one program for everything, you know. So it's a very rich part of the game, but everything works with the same mechanics.
Okay.
So once you are in the position or that extends your influence over the troop,
mm-hmm.
You can execute those programs. I have here a chart.
Okay. Yep.
A very revealing chart. Okay. And this will help me to explain how that hacker goes in 3rd edition, okay? This is the chart, okay? Let's take a look at it. Let's explain, as we have been doing with all the charts
of
close combat and weapons,
week.
Because it's a best way to explain things, simply because of that. Name of the program, modifier for the attacker, modifier for the enemy, as you can
see yeah.
close combat works very similar, okay? Damage, burst, objective, kind of order and status, the result of this program.
Okay.
So, for this program that belongs to the category Info War, okay,
mm-hmm.
there is this program named Gotcha.
Gotcha.
Okay, Gotcha. Which has a 0 modifier for, let's say that I am the hacker, you are the objective.
Mm-hmm.
0 modifier for me, 0 modifier for you, okay. Damage 13. So now hacker programs has this damage.
So they all have a damage that they deal against the enemy. Okay.
So this means that if I succeed, you will have to make a roll using BTS. Because now BTS is no longer a negative modifier in the willpower roll,
mm-hmm.
that kind of stuff. Now it's like the armor of hacker attacks.
So BTS no longer subtracts from the willpower of the attacking hacker. It's now if the hacker succeeds, BTS acts like armor.
In fact, it's no longer a negative number,
yeah.
it's a positive number, and it's like the armor for the hacking attacks,
okay.
that kind of stuff. And usually BTS is 0, 3, 6, 9, goes in those modules.
Goes in those increments.
So suddenly we have something like infantry, medium infantry, heavy infantry, tanks, you know?
Yeah.
And suddenly these interventors are like the tanks, because they have BTS 9. So if they are attacking another hacker and receiving that kind of attacks, you know, damage 13 attacks, they have this armor value, this BTS value of 9, which with a roll plus 9, they will survive to many attacks, okay?
Okay.
So, burst. Now, programs of the hacking world have burst. So, if you're an active turn, you will be using the whole burst, but if you're an ARO, you will be using just burst 1.
So, same as with weapon fire, you only roll 1 dice on the reactive turn?
Yeah. That's it. So that means that some programs will be just verse one, and you will realize, but they are very powerful, so I will use that as an ARO.
Okay.
Moving on. Objective. So the programs are very specific. So some of them will be for against hackers. Some of them will be against tags. Some of them will be against hackers, tags, remotes, and heavy infantry, all the technology altogether. But some of them will also work against everyone.
Everyone.
Anyone, you know, because during this stage of the process of working for the edition, we decided that hackers have to be more powerful because they are very expensive. Okay. You know, they were already expensive in second edition, but they didn't have that meaning in the table. They deserve more power. And what cannot happen is the Ariadna will be completely away from the whole question of having hackers. We will be laughing at the hackers, laughing at the robots of everyone. Okay, the Ariadna must have a little envy of the hackers, you know, because they are the low-tech faction and they have to realize that they do not have pretty toys like hacker and remotes, and hacker and remotes have to be more effective.
Okay. So every hacker program can now target a different thing. For example, Gotcha can target tags, heavy infantry, remotes, and other hackers.
Yes.
Okay.
Overlord can target only tags, which is the program that you will use him for possessing a tag. But Spotlight, which is here, the third program, is for everyone.
So Spotlight can target anybody.
Spotlight is forward observer used by a hacker in its own control, or it's extended zone of influence as a hacker. And with that, you can make forward observer role and mark with the targeted status that we discussed before.
In the previous video, yep.
With to anyone. So that, for example, is a good example because makes hacker useful against Ariadna.
Yeah.
For example, okay.
Okay. So what about the status here of the different ones? For example, the status of Gotcha?
Gotcha, back to the beginning. You can Gotcha, you can use it in active turn as a solid skill or as an ARO. Okay. And it generates the immobilized level one for two turns.
Okay.
Level one, but at the end of the second turn, it gets that marker gets out of the table and the troop is already active. Okay, not
so,
immobilized.
As we discussed in the previous video, there's an immobilization level two, which is you are stuck that way until you're fixed. And level one, you stay that way for how many turns it stays in effect. And in this case, it's two turns.
That's it. So, Overlord for possessing a tag. Zero modifier for me, zero modifier for you. A little more damage, just one dice, and can be used both as an active or reactive turn. And generates the possessed state. You go then to the part of states and you will read how possessed works in third edition. It's like that. Spotlight, we have said it. Okay. It's a solid skill, so it cannot be used as an ARO.
Yep, so okay. There's no ARO for this one.
Yes, it has a minus three modifier, so it's a little bit difficult. Okay. But, you know, I know that this, if you go to the whole description of this program, there is no way of defending yourself from this program. While the other programs are considered attacks, this is something that is a normal role just for the hacker. Okay, but you usually can defend yourself for all the hacker attacks by reset. And reset is something that all the heavy infantry and tanks and other hackers can do. If there is no other option, like dodging, against suits, you can always reset. Okay, and that will be a willpower roll face to face. Okay.
Okay, yes.
So I'm telling you this because now you realize that everything goes with a willpower roll face to face. And if I win the attacker hacker, then you will have to make a BTS roll. There are two roles here, unlike second edition, which was one roll.
There's now two roles.
Two roles. So while hackers are more powerful because they have all these programs, okay, at the same time, the chances of survival against a hacker attack are two roles. This means there is more randomness here, more chances of survival, real.
Okay.
Okay, moving on. Infowar, blackout. Blackout is a way of dealing with troops with a repeater or any kind of communication device that is really meaningful in the game, because maybe we're having a very intense hacker war here. And instead of going for the troop, you go for the device. So, and you can also deactivate deployable repeaters with this.
Okay, so you can deactivate anything that has a repeater and any deployable repeaters.
Yes, anything that has the sticker of communications equipment.
Communications equipment, okay.
So it's damage 15, one dice, short skill and arrow, and it creates the status disabled.
Disabled.
So that Fast Panda, for example, will get disabled. Okay. So moving on. HP Brain Blast, Anti-Hacker Protocols Brain Blast.
So this is the aggressive anti-hacker attack.
Yes, in fact, the only objective that can be chosen using this program is the hacker.
So it's only against enemy hackers, okay?
That's it. 0-0, damage 14, burst 2.
Burst 2 dice, so 2 dice on this one.
Yeah, but you also can use it as an arrow, but just one, as the chart says. And it creates one physical wound. Okay, so the way hackers attack their brains, okay, using the hacker tools that they have. Another program, Oblivion, very interesting one. 0-0, no modifiers for the willpower roll, okay? Tags, heavy infantry remotes and hackers can be objective of this one, okay? And it's a sword skill and an ARO, and it creates the isolated status.
Which is the one we talked about in the previous video.
Yeah.
It can be caused by EM animation.
Yes.
Yep. Where the unit goes into its own separate combat group.
So looking at this, we can see that we can only target tags, heavy infantry, remotes, and hackers.
Mm-hmm.
But an EM grenade can attack anyone with that. So Ariadnas can suffer EM isolated status. Okay.
And it's got a very high damage of 16 as well.
16, just one dice, can be used as an ARO or sword skill. But generates this isolated status that makes you go to one combat group, and is a way of isolating that troop, and has true meaning in the way of you deal with your army. So it's a very dangerous program.
Oh yes.
One program, Support Word, Upgraded Reaction. This is a program that instead of being an attack against an enemy, is a way of supporting your own army. This is an upgrade that you will apply to your friendly remotes with your hacker.
So hackers can not only attack the enemy troops and do things to the enemy.
Also can enhance and upgrade their own units.
Wow, so that actually makes hackers a lot more effective.
Only remotes, okay?
Only on remotes.
They require the entire order, okay?
Mm-hmm.
It lasts 2 turns and gives the remotes 1+1 to the burst in ARO.
So when lasting 2 turns, that means my turn and your opponent's turn?
Yes.
Okay.
So this is very meaningful because, well, okay, of course we have all the remotes with total reaction, but if you do not have one of those remotes, you can upgrade the soldier remote or the missile launcher remote, for example, and having a +1, which is very, very interesting.
Gives them a much more active chance of rolling extra dice and doing more shots and damage to the enemy.
That's it.
Okay.
And finally, we have here the Combined Army Anti-Hacker Protocol Sucker Punch. I include this in this chart just to let you see that certain factions can get programs just for them. In this situation, Combined Army has a Sucker Punch program, which is another anti-hacker protocols, but more powerful. Okay?
Much more powerful.
With
damage.
A -3 to your willpower, with much more damage. And causes 1 wound, okay? So it's a bit more powerful than Brain Blast.
Okay.
But Brain Blast has burst 2, so this will be probably more useful when using it as an arrow.
And an arrow, you're only rolling the 1 dice.
Yes. So, after dealing with all this information, what happens? It happens that the whole thing about hackers change and the whole way of using them change. And I'm just showing here a few programs. There are lots of programs,
depending on
which hacker device you have. And more interactions with more other skills. Once again, we have to approach to this like a new game totally. And suddenly we realized that there were more hackers in the army list and more situations that we have never seen, because this is a new world that affects the game and makes it richer, you know.
Okay.
Because once you get the mechanics, which is, as you can say, face-to-face willpower and then BTS armor roll, that is the basics, and from that we build with different ammunitions, damages, programs, very rich rules, you know, but with mechanics that is very familiar which is very, very similar to close combat or shooting. Mm-hmm. That's the new hacker stuff.
Okay, Carlos. So we've talked a bit about how hacking is going to change in Infinity Third Edition. I think it's time we saw it in action on the table. So, Carlos, we have an example here of hacking in action on the table. Tell us now what's happening in this particular situation and what's going on with the hackers.
We have a few examples set in this table that I would like to explain of things that actually work in third edition and things that we decide not to allow to happen also. Okay. Because, let me describe the situation here, okay? This miniature here, okay, is a female interventor, an excellent hacker
of the nomads.
And I'm using this panda here just to represent a friendly repeater for her. Okay?
A friendly repeater for the interventor.
Yes, and I'm going to put a few enemies here. Here we have an excellent new playing test by Angel Giraldez, new Terra Vault hacker. Okay? And I'm going to use this black white marker here to represent a friendly repeater for him. Okay. Well, something that we decide not to allow in third edition, but we studied the possibility very seriously, is there is no connection between repeaters when they are enemies. No connection here, okay? Because if at some point one player puts a deployer repeater or makes one repeater troop advance and enters in the zone of influence of an enemy repeater, at some point we study the possibility of the hackers can see each other, can attack each other. Suddenly, if we have three hackers here and three hackers there and suddenly two repeaters are connecting each other, suddenly all the hackers see each other. We decide not to allow that because it led to a situation where multiple very complicated roles were played. It was like having two fire teams seeing each other with no terrain on the table. It was something like that. It leads to an extermination of hackers, two things colliding, one survivor, you know, and nothing else. And then there is nothing with hackers in the table because everybody was using Brain Blast and Sucker Punch and nothing else. And they kill each other. And then all the richness of all the programs that the hacker have are no longer there.
Effect.
So this interventor can use this friendly repeater to attack this repeater, usually blackout for disassembling that repeater. The same happens with this Neo Terra Vault using his repeater to attack this repeater, okay? But he cannot attack her. She cannot attack him.
Because there is
no connection between enemy repeaters.
Yeah.
That is important because we already studied it and we arrived to the conclusion that no, this is not working. Seems exciting because you have the collision of hackers there, but at the end leads to nothing. Mm-hmm. Leads to not moving the troops and not making tactics to really reach the objectives. Mm-hmm. It's just boom, everything explodes and nothing happens. Turn one for the hackers, the first two orders are for the hackers, nothing else, and then they are no longer in the battle.
Okay.
So that is something that we studied and we decided to not allow it. So more stuff really. Another example here, I have here my beautiful female interventor, very powerful, and I have here this huge, super, super, super tag that is the Hotuns from Svalheim, very powerful, with a BTS value of 9, I guess.
Yep, big BTS.
Yes, so let's say that this troop here reaches a range to make an attack against this.
Yep,
this
it's inside the zone of control of the
And so let's say that the attack has no line of fire because usually the hackers, because they have this chance of attacking without exposing them to lines of fire, they are usually working, you know, in this corner, trying not to expose themselves from positions of advantage. So let's say that this interventor attacks using a program, let's say Overlord, trying to possess the tag, okay, which is burst 1, damage 14, okay. And the tag. What can do the tag against that? Because Infinity Third Edition always allows the other player to do something.
Yeah, he'll always be allowed to do something against this attack.
Yes, so the tag can declare reset. Reset is like dodging in the hacking world. Reset, okay?
So it's a reset and it's like dodging but for hacking attacks.
It will be a face-to-face roll of willpower of the interventor against willpower of the tag.
So it's straight willpower, no other modifiers?
No modifiers, because the Overlord Charge has no modifiers.
Okay.
And Reset has no modifiers at
reset
all.
Reset has no modifiers.
So it will be pure willpower, face-to-face roll. Okay, mm-hmm. But let's say that the Interventor succeeds at the willpower.
Yeah.
After succeeding, the tag will have to make a BTS roll, mm-hmm. Looking at the damage of the program, which is 14.
14.
Okay. Rolling the dice, adding the BTS and overcoming 14 will decide if the tag suffers. It's the same as an armor value.
Same as the
armor. It's possessed
value.
Or no.
Okay.
Let's say that the tag overcomes that damage.
Yeah.
Okay, so what happens here? The tag has suffered an attack and survived. The tag can fail the guard's roll, mm-hmm. for moving away 2 inches, okay?
Ah.
And getting out of the zone of control of the hacker.
So now being hacked and surviving against a hacking attack is exactly the same as being shot and surviving.
And it was like that always. Yeah. It's an attack and you have survived, so you can move. Okay.
So you can now move out of
the
range of the
hacker. But the hacker, there is no rule in third edition that doesn't allow her to move again, have the hacker the attack again in position and try to hack in again, mm-hmm. and he is allowed to reset again. This can happen many times, but remember, moving the stuff in Infinity is always risking. There's always lines of fire, enemies, mines, lots of things happening. Also, that this tag, just because failing the guard's wall, probably can turn around. Maybe in the next order, suddenly the terrain makes the tag allows to see the hacker, and the hacker is not so interested in a direct confrontation. Many things can happen, but this is the basic mechanics of hacker in third edition. After many testings, we realized that the community of players will come with their own tricks using these rules. We were using lists with 3 hackers, for example. And an Spectre with a deployable repeater, mm-hmm. because the Spectre is no hacker, no heavy infantry, no remote or tag, so he cannot be chosen as an objective for many programs, mm-hmm. but he can deploy the repeater. So suddenly it was very interesting to put a repeater next to an enemy tag and do nothing else. Just wait for the turn of the enemy, because he won't be moving the tag unless someone destroys the repeater, so that consumes orders. And if the tag moves with a repeater there, and I have 3 hackers, all of them will make an ARO. And that's lots of rolls, lots mm-hmm. of chances of really immobilizing, possessing the tag, lots of really damaging stuff. So it is terrific, really.
Okay.
Because now we have the charts with lots of options. And anything can happen. So very, very interesting set of rules. So apart from all this, that is the reason why we made the pandas. Okay, the rules of the pandas they are just repeaters, really. Mm-hmm. They have a little special rule, but the sculpture value of the pandas, the importance that they are going to have, the attention that they will have with this new hacker stuff, leads us to make the pandas. I mean, the mana is beautiful, but if something like this repeater has such an importance in third edition, you know, make the miniature, make something, because it leads up to that. The super warriors now of the hacker war are the interventors, and suddenly they have this kind of stuff, because we know that these hacker rules are very, very interesting.
Okay. Okay, Carlos, thank you for talking us through hacking rules in Infinity 3rd Edition, and thank you for watching.